asking what steps are in place to prevent skydiving accidents like this one. CBS 13's Angela Musalem is here with that part of the story. Angela?
Well, Tony, it takes years for a skydiver to become a certified instructor, and after they're certified, they have to continue flying in order to stay current. Well, today we spoke with safety and training officials who explained and showed us the process.
We're going to throw out a little parachute that's called a drogue.
Greg Foster is the chief skydiving instructor at Skydance in Davis. He's made over 13,000 jumps in his 21-year career.
I do between 25 and 40 jumps a week.
But it took hundreds more jumps and years of training before Foster was able to latch on to students as an instructor in a tandem skydive.
A person has 3 years of parachuting experience, at least 500 jumps.
Jim Crouch is the director of safety and training for the U.S. Parachute Association. He says skydivers training to become certified instructors must also pass at least 10 training jumps with an examiner and a tandem instructor acting as a student. If they pass,
they have to make a minimum of 15 tandem jumps per year to be considered current.
We also wanted to know what the regulations are for skydiving facilities like Skydance to keep their equipment in good working order.
Every 25 jumps, the tandem rig gets done, goes to the loft. The loft, they hang it up, inspect the main parachute.
Foster says the safety advisors are looking for abnormalities in the parachute or general signs of wear and tear. Faulty parachutes are tossed out and replaced. Foster knows there's a risk every time he flies, but he says it's all about repetition and experience.
We know it's risky. We assess that, we minimize it, and then we go do it anyway.
Yeah.
And according to the USPA, millions of jumps are made each year nationwide with only a handful of safety complaints.
So, Angela, is there more than one agency where skydivers can go to become certified instructors?
No, Sam. The USPA is currently the only FAA accepted organization that licenses skydivers across the country.
Mm-hmm.
All right, and Tony, this one to you. The Skydiving Center's owner didn't talk today, but he did talk with us after that accident. So what did he have to say then?
Yeah, I reached him by phone today, spoke with him, but he said no comment. I said what I wanted to say on Saturday. Bill Doss is his name. At the time, he called it an unfortunate accident, saying that just like in the sport of scuba diving and skiing, there are going to be fatalities.
All right, Tony and Angela, thank you both very much. Appreciate it. An update for you now.